Hey guys, it's Kelly. Welcome back. Today's video is going to be just kind of a fun chatty one. I wanted to talk about celebrity makeup lines. I've had this on my to film list for a while now. I thought it would be a fun topic to just chat about and discuss. And I feel like these days I like any distraction, anything just kind of lighthearted. So we're going to talk about celebrity makeup lines today. Before we jump in, I did film this whole look. I filmed my eyeshadow that's gonna be up on my Instagram. I don't think it's up at the time that this video is going up, but I did film it using my favorite palette, Sigma Enchanted. And then I did film this hair as well. These are the heatless curls that I mentioned in my March favorites, and I filmed that on TikTok, and that video is actually up already if you're interested. All right, so in this video, we're just gonna be talking celebrity makeup lines. I'm not talking makeup artist created lines. We're not talking influencer lines, and we're not talking celebrity collabs with other brands. I thought about including those, but that would be so many brands if we talked about all of them. So in this video, we're gonna keep it just to celebrity makeup lines. So I was doing a lot of research last night. I was looking into celebrity makeup lines that I'd never even heard of. I have some on this list to talk about that you might not have heard of either. Some of these were so fascinating to me. Some of them that were around for a little while are not anymore. Some we might remember. But I feel like we have to start this video off talking about probably what I would consider to be the top dogs, the ones that are the most well-known. Like when we think of celebrity makeup lines, there are two very successful ones that immediately come to mind for me, and it's Fenty Beauty, started in 2017, which was interesting for me when I looked that date up. It almost feels like Fenty has been around for both longer and not quite that long. What do you guys think? I was almost expecting the date to be further back, but also more recent. I don't know. But the other one I think is kind of top dog, the one we think of when we think of successful celebrity makeup lines, Kylie Cosmetics. And that brand was started in 2014, and I thought it was almost sooner. I was thinking like 2015, 2016 maybe. And to be honest, it was probably like 2015, 2016 when the brand really started to evolve and grow, because they started out with a very small line just doing the lip kits and only having a few select shades, and they've evolved into a full brand at this point with most products for a full face of makeup. Now, one thing I thought was really unique about Fenty in particular is that they initially launched at Sephora. With a lot of these other brands, they start kind of on their own and eventually make their way into some of the mainstream retailers, but Fenty launched right away with Sephora, and I would like to think that that attributed to a lot of the success. Not to say Fenty would not have been successful either way, because I'm confident that they would have, but that accessibility of being at Sephora, I think, definitely helped the brand and also generated a lot more interest. And you can go into the store, you can swatch it, you can see the products, versus brands that are only sold online do have some limitations, which I think Kylie Cosmetics is a great example of that. They started only selling online, and they definitely, I won't say they struggled in the beginning because they were very successful, but they had a lot of launches where they sold out quickly, the website crashed, and only being sold through their website definitely had some limitations, but now they're actually sold at Ulta as well. So let me know down below if you guys think these are probably like the top two celebrity brands that come to mind. Because for me, like my first one that I thought of was Fenty, but then I was like, you know what? I would say Kylie Cosmetics is quite well known as well. Very, very successful, undeniably. And then kind of my honorable mentions for very well known, very established celebrity brands. This first one, controversial as it is, it's hard to deny this has been historically a successful brand, and that's Kat Von D, sold at Sephora. Now, I don't want to talk too much about Kat Von D because that's not what this video is about, but she definitely had a falling out over the last few years with some controversy surrounding Kat Von D herself. And actually, just a few months ago, she separated all ties from the brand, and they're now actually rebranding into KVD Vegan Beauty, no longer associated with Kat Von D herself. Which, side note, I would love to hear from you guys down below. Does that change your opinion on Kat Von D? Are you more likely to purchase from the brand? I'd love to hear your thoughts on that, because that's something that I find very fascinating. But also, in my kind of honorable mention for that top spot, we have KKW. Now, KKW, I think, is very fascinating because the brand is similar in concept to Kylie Cosmetics. They're both under the parent company of Seed Beauty, which is also under the same umbrella as ColourPop. So they're able to produce products pretty quickly. They kind of work under the same concept as Kylie Cosmetics, and KKW is now sold in Ulta as well. Personally, I have not tried anything from KKW, but if I'm being honest, it is a brand that I'm interested in, specifically the lip liners. Whenever I hear people talking about KKW and their favorites and standouts from the brand, usually I'm hearing something about the lip liner. So if you guys recommend those, let me know down below. But the other one is a brand that not everyone realizes was started by a celebrity. And I'm using started by a celebrity loosely, because with each of these brands, the actual tie to that person can vary. But Flower Beauty is by Drew Barrymore. And Flower Beauty is a brand that's seen a lot of success as well. They're sold in Walmart and Ulta. However, I have had some comments from subscribers recently saying that in your Walmarts and your Ultas, not that we're shopping for makeup right now and not that Ulta is open right now, but a couple weeks ago, I was getting comments that they were starting to clear out the Flower Beauty sections. But then I also got a comment from someone saying that they're rebranding or repackaging or something. So if you guys know anything about that, let us know down below. But over the last few years, Flower Beauty has become a very successful celebrity brand. It's actually, looking over my list, it's the only drugstore slash affordable brand that we're going to be discussing in today's video. And that's one thing that I think is really cool about Flower Beauty, is that it is accessible to more people. Maybe I won't use the word accessible, because depending on where you live and what countries you live in, it's not necessarily a huge international brand, but the price point is accessible. Now, a brand that I kind of thought would have more success than it did is the Lady Gaga brand House Laboratories. So I know a lot of people were really interested about this when it was first announced that she was coming out with her own makeup line. One thing I found very strange and possibly a downfall for the brand is that they're sold exclusively through Amazon. Now, I do appreciate that it does make it accessible, but I feel like it almost hurts the brand in that sense. I would rather see her have a partnership with a store like Sephora or Ulta. I feel like not only would that add to the legitimacy of the brand, but it would open it up to a lot more shoppers, specifically Sephora. I could see a lot more success of this line if it was sold at Sephora instead of Amazon. But also, I feel like the products and the line don't necessarily fit Lady Gaga and her aesthetic, which for her brand would be the reason a lot of people were interested. So I just feel like there's a big disconnect there, versus when you look at KKW or Kylie Cosmetics, all of their products really emulate the makeup style of both of those celebrities, but we don't really see that with House Laboratories, and I do feel like that kind of hurts the brand. Another one, not everyone realizes this, but Jessica Alba is actually the one who started Honest Beauty. They're sold at Ulta and Target. I have not tried anything from Honest Beauty, but I feel like recently they've been gaining a lot of momentum here on YouTube. I've heard a lot of people talk about them and discuss them, and I feel like this brand definitely fits her aesthetic and feels very Jessica Alba to me. Okay, one I did not know until I was researching for this video, the brand Cora Organics was started by the Victoria's Secret angel Miranda Kerr. I thought that was really interesting. This is a pretty successful brand sold at Sephora, more focused, of course, on skincare, but I did not even realize that she was the founder. A brand that I thought was going to be a little more successful a few months ago when it was first announced is the brand by Millie Bobby Brown. She started a makeup line, kind of makeup skincare line, aimed at tweens, and this is the Florence by Mills line. The packaging is adorable. I love the purple. It's just very well themed. But I know there were some controversies with this, with her showing the products but not actually using them on camera. But I'd love to hear from you guys if you've tried anything from this line. What do you think? For me, the concept of a line aimed more towards tweens is definitely interesting. That's not to say that they couldn't just use any makeup, because makeup truly is for any age, any gender, anyone. But I can definitely see where her audience in particular would be interested in this. They're sold at Ulta, which again, I feel like for a lot of these brands, when they initially launch at one of these big retailers like Ulta or Sephora, that definitely lends to some success of the brands, because not only does it make them a little more accessible, but it also generates a lot more buzz because you're seeing it in stores. A brand that I've had my eye on is Victoria Beckham Beauty. Now, this is definitely more of a luxury price point, which definitely fits the celebrity here. I just think of Posh Spice from my Spice Girl obsessed days, and this collection and this line definitely fits her and her aesthetic. Honestly, I've heard a lot of buzz about this brand on YouTube recently. If you guys have tried anything, let us know. But one that's coming soon that I'm really, really curious about is the new line from Selena Gomez. So according to their social media, the brand Rare Beauty will be coming summer 2020. I don't know if that time frame is going to end up being pushed with everything that's happening in the world right now. I'm not sure if that will stick to that timeline or not. We'll just have to wait and see. But what's really interesting, they're launching at Sephora, which, like we said with Fenty, definitely played a role in some of the buzz about the brand. So I'm curious to see if Selena Gomez's brand will kind of follow some of that success. One thing I did not even realize until recently, do you guys know Selena Gomez is one of the top five most followed people on Instagram? So she definitely has a lot of eyes on her, and I'm pretty sure that her brand will as well. So I'm curious to see if that will lend to a lot of additional success for Rare Beauty, kind of where this brand is going to go. All right, we talked about some well-known celebrity brands, some successful celebrity brands, some up-and-coming brands. Let's talk about the, like, where are these now? Like, what happened? Do you remember these? Have you ever heard of these brands? Okay, first of all, did you guys know that Ashley Tisdale used to have a makeup brand? It was called Illuminate, and it actually started with BH Cosmetics. If you guys remember, she did a collaboration with them a while ago. So it kind of started out under the umbrella of BH Cosmetics, and then from what I could find, she took over the brand. But in 2020, she actually shut down the brand, saying that, you know, she had too much going on with film and television, and she wasn't able to focus as much on the brand as she wanted to. But I thought that was really interesting. I had no idea that she had her own line. Also, honestly, there's a lot of Disney stars in this video. Bella Thorne, she kind of had a makeup line for a little bit there. It was called Filthy Fangs, which from what I could find, I could not find any of her products sold anywhere. I couldn't find anywhere that I could purchase them today in 2020. But in 2018, she did have a palette come out, which had some controversy because a lot of people said it looked similar to palettes from other brands, specifically Juvia's Place. But from what I could find, Filthy Fangs seems to now have evolved kind of more into like her lifestyle brand, encompassing a lot of things, but not specifically focused on makeup anymore. But that was her plan for a while there, to have a makeup line. Just like Hailey Bieber, she actually did trademark the name Bieber Beauty in 2019, and I'm curious to see if anything will come of this. I know right now that she does work with Bare Minerals, so I don't know if maybe we haven't seen anything from her brand yet because she still does have a contract with them. I'm not sure. I'm not sure if anything will come of this, but they did trademark that, which I thought was interesting because if you guys remember, like, way back in the day, Justin Bieber did some cosmetic launches, not necessarily his own brand, but he did have some fragrances, and then he did a collab with OPI. And back when I wasn't cruelty-free and I purchased from OPI, I had quite a few of the Justin Bieber colors, and there was this one, like, beautiful green that I would wear all the time. I can still picture it. It was, like, my all-time favorite nail polish color. Do you guys remember the Justin Bieber nail polishes from, like, way, 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 way back in the day? And the last one, I wanted to save the best for last because I thought this was hilarious. Jessica Simpson used to have a makeup line called Dessert Beauty, and the products were edible. This was back in the early 2000s. This brand does not exist anymore, but when I was looking up brands for this video, I had no idea that this was a thing, and I thought that was so fascinating. Edible makeup. Don't really know why there would be a need for that, but back in the early 2000s, this did exist by Jessica Simpson. So I hope this video was kind of a fun distraction for you guys. I know I'm kind of looking for any distraction to get my mind off things recently. So hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, let me know by giving it a thumbs up. And I will go ahead and see you in my next video. Bye.